whilst I was on my return trip from Aran to Saugor, that I heard from a palki bearer of the wonders of this place, Khajuraho.
Mahesham Rajatagirinibham Charucham.
In the 19th century, a British officer, T.S. Burt, chanced upon the ruins of the city of temples. Abandoned for more than 700 years. This ancient site of forgotten grandeur is today one of the most alluring temple sites in India.
I was much delighted at the venerable and picturesque appearance these several old temples presented as I got within view of them.
Ever since Burt's discovery of Khajuraho, the temples have generated certain questions in the minds of the scholars. Why have so many of the temples fallen into disuse? The group of temples are a chance composition? Or are they a part of a planned complex? Some of these questions are yet to be answered. Even then, Khajuraho can be appreciated by a visitor in many ways. As a scholar, as a connoisseur of art, as a social historian, or as a common man who finds in Khajuraho an equation for the interrelationship of religion and intricacies of life, rendered in winsome sculpture by the gifted artists of the Chandella dynasty. The evolution of architectural and sculptural form of Khajuraho began around 850 AD with this 64 Yogini temple, dedicated to Shakti and her battle-thirsty assistants. Made of coarse-grained granite with a certain rugged masculine strength. The Vaman temple lies to the northeast of the main temple complex. An inscription of Harshadeva suggests its date of construction around 1075 AD. Here, Vishnu is represented as the dwarf Brahmin asking the demon king Bali for a gift. The Jangha, or outer wall, is decorated with exquisite sculptures. Javeri is about 200 meters to the south of the Vamana, a temple dedicated to Lord Vishnu. Golden khajur tree that adorned the ancient city gates of Khajuraho. It is believed the name Khajuraho itself evolved from those golden khajur trees. This decorated arch is a characteristic of the medieval temples of Gujarat. Parshvanath, built in the period between 950 AD to 970 AD, a fine example of Nagara style of temple art. The temple is now dedicated to the 23rd Jain saint. Notice the artistic imagery and wide variety of subjects. The most important feature of this temple is the depiction of Ram and Sita, in accordance with the Padma Puran, a Jain holy scripture. To the north of the Parshvanath, a century later, the Adinath temple was built, a small Nirandhara style of temple. The outer walls are again studded with exquisite sculptures. 3 kilometers south of Khajuraho, in the village of Jatkari, this is the Chaturbhuja temple, constructed around 1100 AD. The temple is dedicated to Lord Vishnu. The image stands 11 feet from its base, an expression of transcendental bliss. Dulhadeo Temple is the concluding site among the series of temples constructed in Khajuraho around 1150 AD. The name Dulhadeo suggests the bridegroom's temple. It was built to commemorate the death of a legendary prince who died heroically on the way to his marriage. Considered as the pinnacle of Khajuraho temple art.
Probably the finest aggregate number of temples congregated in one place, and all are within a stone's throw of one another.
Bert's name will always be linked with the rediscovery of Khajuraho. His report of 1839 is the first European description of these temples. It gives a thrilling account of what Khajuraho looked like almost 150 years ago. In Hindu mythology, Earth is personified as a beautiful goddess, and Varaha, the boar incarnation of Vishnu, as the one who saved her from the floods. The statue is about 6 feet in height. These are 674 figures of gods and goddesses carved on the glossy surface of the statue. One of the most beautiful pieces of architectural genius gifted by the Khajuraho artist, the Lakshmana Temple. Built between 930 to 950 AD by King Yashovarman, the temple is dedicated to Lord Vishnu. The temple plan is an example of a Khajuraho design at its perfection. All of the 5 components that complete the architectural scheme in the rest of the Khajuraho temples are present here. A decorated doorway, a marvel of stone carving. Lakshmi, the goddess of wealth, wife of Vishnu, with Brahma, the lord of creation, and Shiva, the Lord of Destruction, the 10 incarnations of Lord Vishnu. Lakshmana Deva is an outcome of long experience in stone carving by the Khajuraho artist. Here he attains proficiency in the massive triple registers of Jangha sculptures. This cosmic alignment of Vishnu Varaha, done to perfection, seems to be inspired by his celebrated forerunners of the Gupta period. Friezes are decorated with different motifs. Hunting, battle, processions of elephants and horses, domestic life, elephants depicted with natural humor. Standing on the same terrace are the shrines of Vishwanath and Nandi facing each other. The temple stands at 89 feet from the ground. This is one of the most important of the Shiva group of temples. Vishwanath portrays the central Indian architectural movement in its richest and most finished expressions. Nandi, Shiva's vehicle, awaits with somber dignity. The temple has indeed the most proportionate sculptures, with admirable poise and grace. This inscription of the Vishwanath temple, written in Sanskrit verse using Nagari script, it refers to the kings of Chandella dynasty, the makers of the Khajuraho. The inscription further refers to the dedication of two lingas, one made of emerald and the other of stone, built by the Chandella king Dhangadeva in 1002 AD.
Suryad bhavanti bhutani suryena palitani tu.
Built around 1100 AD, the Chitragupt is dedicated to Surya. Chitragupt is the assistant of Surya who maintains records of everyone's life.
Suryad bhavanti bhutani suryena palitani.
The Jagdambi temple was originally dedicated to Lord Vishnu, but now it enshrines an image of Parvati. Painted black, the image of Parvati is known as Jagdambi or Kali. Two central rows on the walls contain major sculptures of varying aspects of Vishnu. The sculptural art of Khajuraho has a peculiar flair of its own. Almost all the figures, especially the females, are shown in tribhang or atibhang, or extreme bend of the body along the flexible path. The Kandariya Mahadev, the tallest and the grandest of all Khajuraho temples, dedicated to Shiva, the Lord of the world. One of the finest achievements of Indian temple architecture. The entire shrine is draped and outlined by the sky, the grand Shikhar, intricately ornamented, somewhat restless in movement, but unified in theme and design. The Shikhar appears like a peak, giving a look of a mountain range. The name Kandariya refers to the ascetic one who dwells in mountain caves. Four subsidiary shrines at the corners have perished. But the main shrine is in excellent condition and inspires the beholder by its majestic size and the perfect symmetry of its features.
Temples of Khajuraho is the celebration of the union of Shiva and Parvati, which is the ultimate goal of life.
The Khajuraho temples are bound by a central theme, the divine ecstasy of Shiva and Parvati, with all its philosophical meaning, the unending dialogue between form and formless. In its various temple sculptures, the artist has captured the Puranic tale of the birth of Kamdev, the god of desire, and the marriage of Shiva and Parvati. The sculptures are set in narrative format. When seen together, they tell the story of the divine marriage. All the gods and goddesses come in for the marriage procession. Shiva, the bridegroom. Saptamatrika, who helped Shiva with his dresses. And the women of the city left whatever they were doing to see the divine bridegroom. A woman was in the midst of her bath. She was putting on her makeup. She was breastfeeding her child. This lady was applying coal in her eye. She was about to throw the ball. They all came running to watch the bridegroom, and the master craftsman of Khajuraho made them immortal by freezing them in stone. may Shiva, while jesting with his beloved wife Parvati, be for your welfare.
Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushti Vardhanam Urvarukamiva Bandhanam Mrityor Mukshiyam Amritat. Om Triyambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushti Vardhanam Urvarukamiva Bandhanam Mrityor Mukshiyam Amritat. Om Triyambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushti Vardhanam Urvarukamiva Bandhanam Mrityor.